Hey, how you doing? Andy with you for another gear review. Today we're taking a look at Ibanez's Tube Screamer, the TS7. This is part of the Tone Lock range, and I believe it is the cheapest bunch in their range, the Tone Lock. And I've had this, it's actually my pedal. I've had it for probably about 5 years now, and I was using it pretty much non-stop in my previous band, where I was playing a lot of sort of lead guitar lines, complimentary over the top of acoustic. And it's great. It's got a real character to it. For a pedal that's under $100, it's kick-ass. I'll give you links at the end as well, so you can check out more details. And if you need to buy one, that sort of thing, I can give you a link to where you can get one for a good price. So, let's have a good look at it. I've started off here with our drive down pretty low. I'm just playing through a PV Express 112. It's like I picked it up for $250 secondhand. I just use it for teaching. Simple little amp, so if it makes this sound good, it'll sound good through, you know, an even nicer amp. And I'm playing through my Yamaha Pacifica. So, here we go. Give you the clean comparison. So you can see it sort of just fills that out. Beautiful. Only three controls in there. Obviously our drive is our level of distortion, which I'll crank up a little bit. The tone is pretty drastic. It does, you know, it has its own character to it, as opposed to having like a treble and a bass control. But you know, I keep it pretty central, and it does a lot to the sound when you move it around. So you need to experiment a bit to find the sound that you want. Level is just the level in comparison to your clean sound. So that's pretty straight ahead. And I'll tell you about this switch in a moment. But just let's have a listen to that with our bridge pickup. So I'll play our neck first. And you can barely notice it. That's what I like about it. It's real, real subtle. There, we come out with a bit more of a honky sound. All right, back to the neck. Let's crank her up a little bit. I find anything really above 1 o'clock tends to just not be very nice, and that's where I'm going to switch over to the hot setting instead. So yeah, about 1 o'clock is probably as high as you really want to take it, unless you're going for a different sort of sound. So you notice we're getting a bit more sustain there on those notes now. And we're back on the neck pickup. Like about it is it doesn't overall change your attack of your note like most distortions do. They really do some really weird stuff on the front end on your, you know, on that initial. With this, it hasn't really changed it that much, which is, I think it's really important in keeping, you know, the character of the guitar there. Check it out on the bridge. So I was saying, if I take it above one on our drive there, what I'll actually do instead is actually just switch it over to the hot setting. So keeping it there, I'll give you a quick reference here, back on the neck.